Welcome, everyone. How's everybody doing?
It's good to see a full house. Thank you all for coming out. It's good to be in the post-COVID era. We've got two artists this evening for you guys, both that live in Nashville and do original music and singer-songwriter. So after these guys, stay tuned. Molly Stevens will be up with her trio. We've had Molly a number of times, and she always does a great job here. And we've had these guys as well a few times. So I think you guys are going to be real pleased with the music tonight. And we really appreciate you guys being here and not having to remind you about the mask. It's all good. I did want to point out that there is a small vessel up here. And while you did pay money to get in to see the show tonight, if you feel like supplementing these guys, you can do that right there in that jar that we affectionately call Anita. Anita C. Cash right there. And Anita accepts all denominations, so don't feel like you need to restrain yourself if you feel like it. So you guys ready for a little live music? All right, from Nashville, if y'all would please make welcome A Tale of Two.
Thank you. Thank you, y'all. We are so excited to be back here. Seeing some friends. I'm so excited. Yes. So we are Taylor 2 from Nashville. We are releasing an album in September. And so thank you. Thank you. That was our COVID project. It was great. Should have been out 2 years ago, but what are you going to do? It's all about time. So this next song is the first single that we just released, like 2 weeks ago?
Yeah.
So this is a preview of what is to come. So I hope you like it. Last time's coming round again. Lord, he's on another bend. Listen how this rooster crows at dawn. Another empty promise coming on. I've been on this train 1,000 times, jumped by many a loving lie, thick like sweet molasses on the tongue. But honey child, your rambling days are done. You say you will, but you won't. Say you do, but you don't. And I cannot do this no more. You ain't nothing but a fool. Nothing but a fool.
She wrote that song about me.
Pretty much. Much. All right, so I love anything that's prohibition based or the era that I wasn't born in, basically. And I love to read biographies and hear stories about people and try to figure out who they were. So I wrote a song about, well, we wrote a song about a pair of outlaws. My question was, who were these people really? Was it the myth? Or is it, did you just get caught up in something you couldn't get out of? So that's what this song's about. Growed up in the gutter of the West Texas slums. Two hearts blazed and couldn't be caged, so they lived life on the run. Times was hard everywhere, not much left to choose. But steal a car and drive it far and fast like lovers do. Was it just a joyride to have a little fun till things got out of hand? Then nothing could be done. Was it cruel intention? Was it suicide? A true romance turned deadly dance for two kids named Bonnie and Clyde. Yeah. The law since he was small, Clyde never had a chance. Bonnie fancied Hollywood, be damned her circumstance. They crossed state lines 100 times, a myth they were to some, until the day their gamble made them murder with a gun. Were they cold-blooded killers, evil at a glance, or depression-era saints fighting for a chance? Were they afraid for choices made? Show these outlaws know they'll never be taken alive. Was it freedom that they seeked? Was redemption out of reach? Could they not afford to ask the Lord to deliver what he preached? Fateful day in May of 1934, the laws had laid an ambush as they drove that stolen Ford. A hail of bullets screamed, no mercy for their sins. It was death for Bonnie and Clyde, together till the end. They were vilified and glamorized like none we'd ever seen. Two bad seeds fulfilling a need to live the American dream. Gone but not forgotten, their story still survives. Their fates align, their souls entwine forever. That's Bonnie and Clyde. I swear, y'all, he plays that song faster and faster every time we do it. Lord, let me breathe. My fault for writing it wordy, but they were so exceptional. Like, I mean, there's so much to say about them. What do y'all think? Were they outlaws or were they just two kids? Two kids. Yeah.
I like to think of that more. Every time we ask that question, most of the time people go, No, they were awful. Like, come on.
Maybe. Who knows? All right. This next song is it's about a thunderstorm and summertime. Thank you. Thank you. All right, so back to this album. thing that we've got going on here. Second single is out July the 9th, and this next song is the second single. Apparently, singles are the thing.
They are the thing.
They are the thing.
This is a tune that was a writing exercise originally to, we found this term called Chicago Lightning, which was a term fire. It was a term for gunfire between cops and Capones. So we wrote a whole song out of slang.
Are
so
y'all gangsters or from Chicago? Or both? I wish some of these words would come back. We've lost a lot of verbiage from the 1920s. That was pretty cool. I think technically this would be considered a blind pig. Isn't that cooler than a bar? I'm going to the blind pig. Get some ossified. I say we bring it back. All right, this next song will be single number 3 in August. And what do you want to say about this song?
Nothing.
Nothing. All right.
It's called Moving the it's called the letter.
Take me in your hand again. Lead me back where we began. I can feel you. I will love you. Hear these words I say. Thank you. We realized once we recorded that song, it's kind of like COVID, wanting to be back with your loved ones again. So we had no intention of that, but kind of worked out that way. Gosh, I don't know why I spend all this time doing my makeup, because I get under lights and I just start crying and looking like a raccoon. Apologize for that. I swear I do try. All right, we are... We're going to do a cover song.
A cover.
So I'm a huge, we are a huge Tom Waits fan. Anyone else like Tom Waits?
All right.
I think I like this one.
I think that man can relate and write a story just about better than anybody else. If I ever meet him, I just want to say, just tell me stories, because you're amazing. And so we came across this song, and it had like 5 or 6 verses, and as much as I love that, I didn't want to keep you here till midnight, so we kind of did our own thing with it and cut some versions out and hope it still tells the tale that he so wonderfully wrote. Obviously, I don't have a gruff voice, but anyway. I said, John, John, he's long gone. Gone to Indiana, ain't never coming home. Fallen James in the Tahoe mud. Stick around to tell us all a tale. Well, he fell in love with a Gun Street girl. Now he's dancing in the Birmingham jail. Dancing in the Birmingham jail. Took $100 off a Slaughterhouse Joe. Bought a brand new Michigan 20 gauge. He got all liquored up on that roadhouse corn. Blew a hole in the hood of a yellow Corvette. A hole in the hood of a yellow Corvette. I said, John, John, he's long gone. Gone to Indiana, ain't never coming home. I said, John. Soaking day old bread and kerosene. He was blue as a robin's egg and brown as a hog. Staying out of circulation till the dogs get tired. Out of circulation till the dogs get tired. Now the rain like gravel on an old tin roof. The Burlington Northern pulling out of the world. Gun Street girl again. Never kiss a Gun Street girl again. I'll never kiss a Gun Street girl again. Never kiss a Gun Street girl again. I said, John, John, he's long gone. Gone to Indiana, he ain't never coming home. I said, John, he's long gone. Gone to Indiana, ain't never coming home. Coming home, he ain't coming home. Gone to Indiana, ain't never coming home. Thank you. Sorry, I almost like killed my friends over
crazy.
There. I didn't want to give
cool.
you a souvenir. Did I?
You're like, bam, get out of here.
Y'all, I obviously do not play an instrument except my voice, and so this is my percussion ensemble, so I hope you like it. It's an old organ thing with a cup. That's all I can do. Sorry. And I can't even do it in time, but you know what? It's all love, so it's all good. All right. This song's gonna be on the album. It's not a single. A little French. A little French inspired, I think.
He's not the one for you, holding you like a prisoner. I'd give my heart to you, but words can get through a picture. Smile and run, hiding it from the altar. I'd bring it back to you when you're across the water, loving you frame by frame.
Thank you.
Let's skip one of these two.
Do you want to stay with me?
Sure. Yeah.
All right. Y'all, we only have time for a few more songs. It goes so fast. I want to thank you all for having us. We love coming to Asheville. We love the city. In fact, this was the last venue we played before COVID hit, and it's our first venue back as a tale of two. So thank you for having us back again. Thank you to my friends for coming out. My new friends I'm going to make tonight. Thank you for being here. This next song was actually the first song we wrote together. Slowly fade. softly gazing down. Hush away all the aching, silence the soul that's breaking down. Thank you. Y'all, we're down to our last song. Thank you. That makes us feel wonderful. At least you're not throwing things like, get off. Thank you for that. My name is Stephanie Adlington. This is Aaron Lessard. We are A Tale of Two. Our full-length album, six-song EP. Not because we didn't want to record more. That's just all we could afford. So that's what we get now. We'll be out in September, and September 19th, and we're on Spotify and all those things, so please look for us, and we hope to be back here very soon. We love this venue, we love y'all, we love Asheville, and thank you.
We do have a, we don't have any merch today, but we have a little email list that you can sign up for. If you sign up, I think we'll allow like email list people to buy the album early. So
sure.
That's worth it.
Yeah. So please sign up so we can keep in touch and let you know when we're coming back. All right. This will be our fourth single and our final song this evening. We want to thank Molly Stevens and her crew.
Yes.
They are awesome. New friends. And she's coming up next. So y'all stick around because she is amazing. All right. Thank you.
good Southern Belle. Don't dare to play, or she'll hurt you like hell. Young Appalachian, born for the run. When the moon is shining and our hands on her gun.
Slick as a whistle, hot off a train. He's a dead man walking, but he'd never complain. Loves like a sinner, smiles like a saint. Talks sweet like whiskey, but bitter to the taste. Thank you.
Well, I walked up to a counter to buy some cigarettes, and standing there beside me was a gal I'd never met. She pulled out her wallet, and much to my surprise, there she held your picture, baby, right before my eyes. You're keeping too many secrets from me. But baby, now you fool me like the others, then I know what you'll do. You'll find yourself a new love, then give me your secret too.
Everybody knows you've been stepping on my toes, and I'm getting pretty tired of it. You keep a stepping out of line and a messing with my mind. If you had any sense, you'd quit. Cause ever since you were a little bitty teeny girl, you said I was the only man in this whole world. And now you better do some thinking, then you'll find you got the only daddy that'll walk the line.
I keep a working every day, all you wanna do is play. I'm tired of staying out all night. I'm a coming unglued from your funny little moods. Now honey, baby, that ain't right. Cause ever since you were a little bitty teeny girl, you said I was the only man in this whole world. Now you better do some thinking, then you'll find you got the only daddy that'll walk the line. Keep a packing up my clothes, nearly everybody knows that you're still just a putting me on. When I start a walking, gonna hear you start a squawking and a begging me to come back home. Cause ever since you were a little bitty teeny girl, you said I was the only man in this whole world. Now you better do some thinking, then you'll find you got the only daddy that'll walk the line. You got the only daddy that'll walk the line.
How are y'all doing tonight? Happy Father's Day, all you fathers out there. Yeah! Y'all give it up for a tell of two one more time. That's what we've been doing this year, right? made it through the COVID. We pray and hope. Sure does feel good back up here playing music for y'all tonight. Thank y'all for coming out. I wrote this song about my hometown of Macon, Georgia. Sitting on a porch swing with an eye on the Georgia sun. Being out on the lake all day, I was wild and on the run. Those days may have come and gone, they remind me of the truth, that these are my roots. Yeah, these are my roots. They run deep, they're strong. Pull me back to where I'm from. Very safe. It brings me back home to my roots. My parents are watching on the Facebook stream, so I want to say happy Father's Day, Dad. We love you. Y'all give them a shout out. Sunday morning church, we were packing in the pew. Thank you all so much. Is everybody having a good night? Yeah, y'all are a good crowd. I like it. On Father's Day here in Asheville. Who's visiting? Raise your hand if you're visiting. Nice. Wow. That's awesome. What a beautiful place to visit, right? It really is. Well, my name is Molly Stevens, and I am happy to be here with y'all tonight. I've got my friend Katie Rogers. and my friend Casey Clark. And we used to do a lot of shows together a couple years ago, and then COVID happened and none of us had a job, and so we didn't play any shows, and this is our first time back as a trio since like almost two years ago. So yeah. So I just released a new song. And a lot of cool things are happening. I mean, last year was hard for sure, but we're on the upside now. And when I wrote this song, I had no idea what the meaning would really be of it. But now that I'm on the flip side, it's really kind of cool. So my wife, who is up here probably talking and having a beer or something like that, hanging out, she and I are adopting a little baby, and we're so excited about it. And when I wrote this song a few years ago, I had no idea that this would be in our cards, and now it makes so much sense, and it's just kind of become this like fun song that I get to sing to myself to continue to give me hope that our child is going to come into our life at the right time, at the right place, and we fully believe that God's going to do that for us. And so this song's called Don't Even Know What Your Name Is. And I keep thinking about it because I'm like, I have no idea what this kid's name's going to be. I have no idea where they're going to come from, but I'm going to love them so hard, and I can't wait. If y'all have any parental advice, find me after the show. I'm sure I'll need it. You know, like just like the major things, like how to keep them safe. And I'm pretty good at changing diapers. But I mean, Ashley already agreed to do all that anyway, so.
Really?
Well, yeah, I'm originally from Macon, Georgia. I lived in Nashville, Tennessee for over 10 years, and now I split my time between Nashville and Raleigh, North Carolina. So Asheville is really the middle spot for me. And so I really love having a foot in both cities. And anyway, it was really awesome to meet Tale of Two tonight. I knew that they were from Nashville, but our paths had not crossed yet. And so it's been really cool. So many great musicians, but weren't they really beautiful? I mean, it was just a beautiful set. So thank you guys for playing.
Thank you.
Y'all are rowdy for a Sunday night now. Calm it down. That's exactly it. And I had to do a little Dolly Parton for y'all. She is my all-time favorite. Did somebody just say Moderna? That's awesome. I love it. You guys are great. So, obviously, I didn't have some wire cutters, so my, you know, going fancy. Just making my dad real proud of my stage presence on Father's Day. That's right. Well, this next song here is a new one as well. It's really fun to get to play new songs. I recorded it last summer out in Nashville and am just now getting to release it. But you know, it's really one of my most special songs that I've ever written, because in this journey that I've had, that for my journey in music, it has been up and down, up and down, and in some really amazing seasons of life where I felt like I was on top, and some really low seasons in life where, you know, I could finally admit and surrender that, like, oh Lord, like, there are a lot of really good musicians out there. And saying that, the biggest gift of all for me in this this 15, or gosh, I've been doing music since I was 2 years old, and that is no lie. But professionally, has been finally being able to get on a stage and feel okay with who I am and be able to voice that and not hide from that and to completely love all of me. And at the end of the day, it's like nothing else matters. That's my Grammy. So this is the song. It's called Completely.
Instead of being selfless, I was being promise me I'll give you all your
Casey, you do not speaking get of which, to
you talked about
or,
Dolly Parton. Oh now gosh. I worked my way up to the microphone.
Here he goes.
I don't know if you saw, but Dolly stopped in here earlier, not long ago. Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. That's just two bald guys standing real close together.
Casey, when you become a dad, you're gonna have the dad jokes like you've already got them down.
I'm already working
yeah,
hard.
Yeah, you got it, man. A lot of times I have to give Casey a pep talk in the green room, like, okay, no dad jokes tonight. Obviously.
Did you tell them I'm a North Carolinian?
Oh, that's right, y'all. Casey's yeah. He's just from right up the road. Up in old Hickory. Hickory. Lenore.
Yeah, close enough.
There you go. Well, yeah, Casey's like my brother from another mother. We kind of look alike.
We do favor each other.
Yeah. I mean, that must mean that you must be real good looking. Because, I don't know. I get that a lot. Well, from Ashley, I do.
This is the part where I'd like to keep my job, so I'm just going to be quiet and play the guitar.
He is a smart man.
They don't teach us a lot in Hickory, but they teach us how to keep our mouths shut.
Pack my bags, gotta hit the road. Oh, to do. Mostly you. I'll soon be home. The crown was kind of small but nice. question this sometimes. A whiskey and coke could get me through, but mostly you.
Thank you, guys. That's a special song to me. Speaking of guitar strings, I've got some merch back there, y'all. I've got some old CDs. In fact, that song that I just sang, Mostly You, I was in a duo. Declan McGarry and I, we were called Me and Molly, and we played here before. He's a Canadian guy and lives in Nashville now. And we parted ways just because he went and raised a family, and it was hard for him to be off the road. And actually, that's a song that he and I wrote about, just the hardships of being on the road and being away from the people we love. And anyway, that song is on a record of mine I've got out there. And I've got some cool T-shirts with some hats on them because I wear hats a lot. And then I've also got these cool they're like incense. They're like, what are they called? What are they called, Ashley? Santo Palo sticks. See, that's why I bring Ashley around, y'all. She knows these answers. They're these sticks that we kind of fell in love with in Tulum, Mexico, and you light it. And for me, it's like a ritual. I do it every morning. It's kind of like my prayer. And it's just like my moment to like light a little bit. And the smell of it's just really, really good. It's like a woodsy kind of smell. And anyway, it's like all bougie and stuff, but it's cool. And if you want some, all that, yeah, that's woo-woo. It's woo-woo, but it's cool. I think it works. Bougie woo-woo, yeah, that's it. Well, we're going to play a few more for y'all tonight. We've had so much fun. It's been such a good time being here in Asheville. I was thinking of, on Father's Day today, I was thinking about my dad, and I got to see him not too long ago. He and my mom came to Nashville last weekend, and then we're gonna meet my family down at the beach next weekend. So I've gotten to spend a lot of great time with them, and I'm super close to my father. And anyway, when I first moved to Nashville, I told my dad, he said, "You got to get a job." And I was like, "Well, I mean, I'm going to be a musician. Like, it's going to happen, like, just like that, overnight, right?" He's like, "Nah, like, you got to get a job and pay the bills. Like, Dad's not doing that for you anymore." And so I remember I was teaching school, and I went and I taught, I guess they were seventh graders. I don't know. They were weird. Seventh graders are weird. And but I loved them because I'm weird, too. And I was sitting there, and we were outside doing a little activity, and all I could do was think about, I would give them a little bit of free time, and in my head, I'd start writing songs. And I knew it was probably not a good thing to do, but I did it. And one day, I called my dad, and I was like, "Dad, I like don't know what to write about." And he was like, "Molly, you gotta write something stupid, just something so dumb that it's gonna make it on the radio, and Zach Brown's gonna wanna record it, and like, just the silliest song you can think of. Like, don't be writing all that heartfelt stuff and who you are. Like, that's all good. But, like, write something just silly." So I came up with this. It was the story of my life, too. Because I was broke, y'all. Broke but tame. Now, Zach Brown didn't record that, but we did get to record it in Zach Brown's studio, so. But, you know, it's catchy, right? So it's now my dad's favorite song, and he totally takes claim for it and says he's a co-writer on it and all that stuff. Well, you always sure have had fun being here with you all tonight. Thank you so much. Thank you, Attila, too, for doing this show with us, and it's just been a, hey, somebody was whistling, I like it. I need to hire y'all next to be a backup singer for me. Backup whistler. Oh, man, now I really will hire you for that. I'll take you everywhere with me. People be like, what? Who is that girl? I don't know, but she hired a professional whistler. All right, y'all. Well, you know, now that we're in North Carolina, we got to take you to the backwoods. We got to take you down home. We got to take you to the part where you better run because you're so scared. Y'all getting scared? Thank you.
church this morning, you need to redeem yourself. Now's your time. Y'all don't know what I'm about to do, but y'all just follow me. This is for my 92-year-old grandmother who is still alive, who told me I could not leave the stage without singing a gospel song.
Hey, we got time for one more. Y'all want to do it? I don't think Katie knows what we're doing, but, you know, she's good. She can do this. I promise.
promise we didn't have that one planned, but, you know, we got out there and I was like, y'all, we gotta do it. They're clapping for us. So let's take it home, y'all, with one everybody knows.
By Katie. You'll kick, you'll get it. You got it.
Very hard to fill his shoes.